家好，我是《日常对话》的导演黄慧珍，然后希望大家可以来看我们的电影。我们在柏林还有三场的放映，一个是今天晚上，然后另外一个两场是2月16号的晚上8点，还有2月17号的下午2点半。希望大家可以来看我们的作品《日常对话》，谢谢。
Hi everyone, my name is Diana Chiawen Lee. I'm the producer of a documentary called Small Talk.We're extremely grateful to be part of the Berlinale this year in the Panorama section. We have 2 more screenings coming up, so if you're interested in seeing the film, please come check it out and visit our website at www.smalltalkthefilm.com. Thank you.
我甲阮就想要了解你啊，你拢毋互了解啊。
Welcome Huang Hui-chen, the director of Small Talk, and Diana Chiawen Lee, the producer of the film. I'm very happy to have you here.
We're happy to be here. Thank you.
开心。
Small Talk is a very intimate portrait about the relation between you and your mother, and your attempt to deal with your very hard past as a family.Slowly you unravel the past by giving a detailed picture of your childhood and making it understandable for the viewer. Why only small talk is possible between you and your mother? Can you explain why?
So he didn't ask the first question, right? He
asked why you and your mother only can talk through everyday conversation to discuss your
因为我跟我妈妈之间其实一直很有距离，没有办法沟通，对，所以我之前试过写字、写东西给她，但是显然这对我们来讲是没有用的，所以后来我就决定我必须要拍一部片子，因为那可以让我比较有勇气去跟她说一些话，或是问她一些问题。
My mom and I have always been distant, and I've tried many different methods to converse with her, to get to know her. I've even tried writing letters to her, and none of it worked. So I finally realized that maybe using film and shooting her and videotaping her is the best way to get close to her and to have a conversation with her.
So before we dive into the topics of your film, I just have a question. When did you come up with the idea of making this movie about this relationship between you and your mother? And how long did it finally last from the very first idea until the beginning of shooting?
最早是在1998年，那时候我20岁，然后因为那年是我的生命中第一次知道有一种电影叫做纪录片。然后那时候我就想要拍一部我们家的影片来诠释到底我们是谁，拥有一个同志的母亲是一个什么样子的情况，当同志的小孩是什么样子的感觉，这样子。所以从1998年
，So the earliest idea came about in 1998 when I was 20. At the time, I came across this form of filmmaking called documentaries, and I realized that there's a way for me to tell my story to the world and to talk about to have the right to tell our story, to talk about what it means to be the child of a lesbian mom. And to tell the story of a lesbian family.
所以从1998年开始拍的话，拍到真正完成是2015年了，所以就是将近对17、18年，快20年的时间。
So from 1998, I started shooting, and then we didn't finish until 2015. So close to 20 years of
that
shooting.
That has been a very long process. Yeah. I see. So once you said have started filming, how many times did you think of giving up? And what did you motivate to continue this process of filming?
在拍摄的中期吧，大概平均一个礼拜，我就想要放弃拍摄，因为那个时候我也同时带着我的女儿，那时候她还小，就是三岁多吧，就是带小孩工作其实很挑战。所以，然后加上其实我们要一直去面对我们过去一直不敢碰触的那些问题，所以大概一个礼拜我就会有一次想要放弃的念头。
So, once we started officially filming, I had my daughter who was very young at the time, and so having to take care of her and filming was very difficult. But also having to constantly talk about difficult issues with my mom during filming was extremely challenging. So I've wanted to give up almost every week.
对啊，可是就很有趣，就是虽然每一个礼拜都想要放弃，可是在每次我想说放弃的同时，又会有一个更大的声音告诉我不能放弃，我得要完成它。然后那个声音也是同样来自于我妈妈跟我女儿，因为我就当了妈妈，其实也意识到时间不会是永远有那么多，就是我如果想要真正改变我跟我妈的关系，我就还是必须把这部片子完成。
So despite wanting to give up almost every week, there's a larger pull and a larger voice telling me to continue to finish filming. And that voice came from my daughter and my mom. Because as a mom myself, I realized that time is limited and I don't have a lot of time. So I must use this moment to really try to tell my mom the things I want to tell her.
That's from the very beginning, you talk about your very ambivalent relationship to your mother between love and hate. And as a starting point, you're dealing with your desire as a kid for motherly love. It's intriguing how you link your mother's homosexuality with your desire for love.Would it have been easier for you to deal with the situation if your mother had talked openly about her homosexuality?
我不觉得如果我妈当时有跟我说她是女同志，我就不会对于她是不是爱我这件事情产生疑问，因为我觉得那并不直接相关。对，可是我觉得比较是她怎么在跟我们相处，因为我就是感受到。好像他就是不需要我们，虽然他生了我们。
So, I don't think that her being gay, and her love or the lack of love for us, or my question of whether she loves us, is linked. It's more the fact that how we, interact as a family and how we are as mother and daughters.That makes it difficult for us because it felt like she didn't need us in her life. So whether she told us that she's gay, whether she openly talked about it, didn't really affect how I felt.
比较有问题的是，我都觉得他比较爱他女朋友，因为我感受到他比较爱他女朋友，比较不爱他的小孩，那个才是我产生疑问的点。
The point of contention or the point of grief for me was more the feeling that she loved her girlfriends more than she loved her kids. So that created more of a problem for us.
Yeah, I mean, you just like mentioned in the film many times your own jealousy towards the lovers of her mother. So was it like a double isolation for you? Made it even like...This double isolation, it harder for you to talk to your mother?
我觉得那也不是因为同志身份，因为我觉得同志身份对我造成唯一的困扰，不是来自于我妈妈是同志，而是台湾社会在那个时候对同志其实非常的不友善。我是因为听到外面的声音告诉我妈妈这样是不对的、不正常的，我才觉得我妈的同志身份对我来讲是有影响，是我不喜欢的。
My mom's sexual orientation or my mom being gay wasn't really a problem within the family, It wasn't so much that the fact that she's gay. It was the way that she was treated or viewed, or how we were treated as a family by the Taiwanese society at the time, because it's not accepted in the society, in the Taiwanese society. So to have that stigma and to be viewed by the society in a certain way was what caused us conflict. So it's the conflict is more from external rather from within the family.
所以真正的困难反而是我们，也许我们的文化就是这样，我们都不去谈论几乎所有事情吧。我们心里真正的感受，我们都不去谈论。所以跟他是不是同志没关系，跟我们整个文化或是我们的家庭的关系就是这个样子。其实困难是来自于那里。
So the conflict is really from external. It could be because of Taiwanese culture and society is just this way, and it creates difficulties and barriers for people to openly talk about anything, not just about being lesbian, about, you know, your sexuality, but it's just difficult for people in the society just to open up to each other. So it makes it even more difficult within a family for family members to relate. So even if she wasn't a lesbian, we would have a hard time relating.
I see. So you are interviewing a couple of your mother's former girlfriends, and the viewer gets a more detailed insight or picture of your mother. So on the contrary to your own experiences as a kid, she's mainly characterized as a very caring and loving person. What kind of effect did these interviews have on you?
感受当然很复杂，就是因为你就看到原来我的妈妈她还是可以对人很好的，只是她都没有用这样子的方式对待她的小孩。可是我觉得那个虽然心情很复权，可是不会让我觉得更不喜欢我妈妈或是什么，因为对我来讲那个过程就是我要去多认识我妈妈的其他面相，她到底是一个什么样子的人，跟那为什么她是这样子。
It felt conflicting and complicated, the emotions when interviewing her girlfriends, because I can see that she has the capability to love, but it didn't cause me to hate her more or to be angry with her more. It just made me realize I need to take the initiative to understand who she is and the many different facets of her.
So I just like switch with my questions and go to the editing. That's done very well.
Thank you.
Gradually, you unravel a second story within the family frame. Towards the end of the film, you finally confront your mother with the fact of sexual abuse by your father. So I did wonder if this was very clear to you from the very beginning of the artistic process, or was it more like something what came up during the process of shooting.
就先谢谢我们的片子的剪辑师跟我们的剪辑指导这样子。那这个议题关于我父亲之间发生的事情，其实我一直都知道我必须要去处理它，面对它，只是会因为它实在太困难了，所以其实我是一直在回避。 但是我同时也知道，如果我不去真正处理它，我就要背着它一辈子。那我背着它一辈子，这些事情、这些问题永远不会改变跟解决我跟我妈的关系也不会真的改变。所以我知道我得要做。然后我运气很好，就是有一个团队的陪伴，然后我就鼓起勇气真的去把它讲出来。而且我觉得很感谢自己有做这件事，因为我觉得真正把这些事情都讲出来了，我跟我妈
So firstly, we want to thank our editor and our editing consultant for helping us create such a great story. Regarding revealing the what happened between me and my dad to my mom, that's something that I knew I needed to deal with, but I've been avoiding But I knew that if I keep avoiding it, it will stay with me for the rest of my life, and it's a burden I have to carry for the rest of my life. So with the help of my crew, and I'm grateful that I'm able to deal with it and face it. And ultimately, I realized that if I don't deal with this and talk to my mom about it, I will never be able to break the wall that's been keeping us from getting close. So I'm happy that I ultimately did it, because I want to be able to knock down that wall.
I did wonder if the camera was a very helpful tool in this process of dealing with a hard task for you.
就一般我们都觉得摄影机会造成距离。 一般来说好像也真的是这样，可是对我来说，我反而觉得在我们的这个片子，或者说我决定把摄影机带到我跟我妈之间的那个生活生命中，反而它是要拉近我们的距离的。因为如果没有摄影机，我可能连去跟她问问题，或是跟她说话的勇气都没有。
We tend to think that the camera creates distance, but for me, it actually was something that pulled us closer together, because without the camera, I don't think I have the courage to get close to her or to ask her some of the questions that I want to ask her.
所以是一开始我就知道摄影机的进来，我觉得不会造成距离，反而是会拉近那个距离，然后它同时也逼迫我自己得要往前一步有行动这样。
So I knew that having a camera and bringing camera into this would actually help pull us closer together, and also encourage me to move forward with this film.
I mean, you can see it in the film. Your mother says many times, stop filming. I can understand totally. So this is what you see. I have two more questions for you. Mm-hmm. So first, how did the creative process of making this film change your attitude towards your mother and towards your own past? Mm-hmm. And second, what kind of changes did this process trigger on your mom's side?
对我来说，我觉得整个片拍摄的过程就是我去学习怎么样真正的理解跟认识一个人，即便他是我很亲近的人。 因为即便很亲近，我觉得都没有理所当然，一定就是我就是很了解他，我们关系一定会很好。没有，我觉得我是透过拍摄这个片子，才在学习这件事情。对，然后。<laughs>
For me, making this film allowed me to realize and understand that just because we're family doesn't mean that we're automatically close, and that we shouldn't take that for granted. That you know, family members. You automatically know each other. So through the process of making this film, I realized, or I learned that I have to learn about my family members and learn the different facets of them.
所以反过来对我自己也是一样，我也透过拍这个片子，重新再理解到底为什么我之前会这样子看待我妈妈，或是我所有那些困惑是怎么回事。
So it applies to myself as well. Through the filmmaking, I had to re-examine myself and my attitude towards my mom. Why did I feel the way I felt in the past about her? Why did I think the way I thought about her?
对，那对于我妈的改变，就是我觉得有两个是特别重要的吧。一个是，因为我们通常都很 静在看自己发生的事，我觉得看不清楚全部的样貌。可是因为我拍了这样一部电影，我妈妈也跟着观众一起看我们的电影。那我觉得那是她第一次有机会在一个比较有距离的状态看到她自己，跟看到她怎么跟我互动，我们的关系到底是什么。我觉得这是改变我们的关系一个很重要的点。And
I think it's applicable to my mom as well, that she living her life every day, it's hard for her to take a broader view of who she is, or to step away from her own life to see who she is. So she's seen the film on the big screen with an audience now, and she's seen how the audience reacts. So it's an opportunity for her to also step outside of herself and see herself in a different perspective, and perhaps reflect on that. And that has helped our relationship and how we deal with each other.
然后另外一个改变就是，我觉得过去他会认为他被家暴很丢脸，那甚至他觉得同志也身份也不应该跟小朋友讲。那我觉得因为片子完成，观众看到的反应其实都是很好的，观众都是喜欢我妈妈这个人的，会拥抱她的，所以我觉得那个也改变了他对于自己过去经历那些事情的一些看法，比如说也许家暴不需要觉得很羞耻，就是然后也觉得他的这样子的生命经历也是有意义的，而不是他觉得的他的人生没有什么好谈，然后是没有意义，就只有苦难而已。
And for my mom also, the other aspect is she used to think that being a victim of domestic abuse or being a lesbian was both shameful. But to be able to see the film with an audience and to see how well the audience responded and to see how supportive the audience are towards her and her plight and her experiences, it confirmed or it helped her to understand thatHer life is meaningful and that she shouldn't be ashamed of who she is. She shouldn't be ashamed of having been abused and she shouldn't be ashamed of her sexual orientation and her preferences. So it really helped her see that her life is meaningful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's amazing if a film can change the point of view or like your attitude towards yourself.
Yeah.
Last question to you, Diana. I mean, how did you meet? And was it like quite directly clear for you that you want to produce this film?
well, we met at a workshop, and I was a new producer arriving in Taiwan from the States, and I was looking for filmmakers to work with. And Hui-chen has never worked with producers before, so she wasn't really sure what a producer does, but she was like, I want to work with you.And initially I was hesitant because of the subject matter, because how personal, and I just didn't know if I'm a right fit. I didn't know how to go into the film, especially because as she says, she's been filming since 1998. How do you work with somebody who has been doing this by herself for so long? But I have to say she was very persistent, and she was very convincing, she wasn't trying to convince me to work with her. She was very convincing in her desire to tell the story and her strength in no matter what, I'm going to tell my story. And I think that comes across as you see in the film.
Absolutely.
So after talking to her for a while, I was like, okay, I'm on board. We're going to do this. Yeah, so it was definitely... An amazing journey, yeah.
And it's an amazing film.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for this interview. So nice to have you here.
Thank you. Thank you so much for you guys inviting us.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.